Edgar Tegley sent me. You know, the famous painter. How about a discount?
Famous painter? Edgar? Yeah, right.
You don't give discounts or you don't think he's famous?
Look, I'm sorry, but eating lunch every day in the art teacher's room does not make you a famous painter. Anyway, you only did that to hide out from the school wrestling team.
Hey, there's no shame in hiding from wrestlers. They're trouble, especially the wild animal type.
Oh, what do you mean, wild animals? Like dogs, huh? Oh, you got a problem with me now?
No. I just meant wrestlers can be tough. I didn't mean you.
Oh, you don't think I'm tough now? Why, 'cause I'm a Dalmatian? Hey, we can't all be St. Bernards and Bulldogs, you know.
Has Edgar always had a problem with wrestlers?
No way. In fact, he used to be the captain of his high school wrestling team. He took them all the way to the state semifinals one year, and then he choked. Cost the team the entire match.
Why did he choke? Did they get him in one of those pile driver things?
No. Edgar's girlfriend, Lana Panzoni, dumped him after the first period for Dean LeGrant, the head of her cheerleading squad. Tegley was worthless after that. The other team just tossed him around the rest of the day like a half sack of pork rinds. Oh, man. His squad hated him after that. The whole school did.
How sad. Especially since it all happened to him again with Dingo and Lampeta.
Oh, right. Yeah, they exist.
Not made up at all, those two.
Sheesh.
Hey, I got some original Picassos over here if you're interested, by the way.
See ya.
Yes, run. Run from the horror. Well, maybe you can write it off on your taxes as a loss. A catastrophic loss, even.
See ya. I'm starting to feel like I'm back in high school, which is weird because I'm only 10. I'm not getting anything. I must be out of range or something. Can't get a good grip.
Introducing, back from a crushing victory at Someone Might Lose a Tooth in Duluth, Eagle!
Caw-caw!
That's it? Caw-caw.
Caw-caw.
Caw-caw. You look pretty jumpy. What's the problem?
I'm supposed to paint an ad for the big fight between Dingo the Matador and the town bull. Only, the bull's on a rampage right through where the painting needs to go.
Dingo the Matador! I need to talk to him!
His apartment's right upstairs. While you're there, maybe you can convince him to take care of the bull.
You're an 8-year-old boy, so regretfully, I'm...
you must be the towel boy. You want an autograph? I don't just hand those out. And that's a good lesson for you. Anticipate disappointment. Take me. I'm the greatest bullfighter who's ever lived, yet my upcoming match against the town bull has received virtually no marketing support. A towering advertisement was supposed to have been painted just outside my window. But as you can see, the job hasn't even been started.
I think that bull is trampling anyone who tries to paint on the wall. Maybe you could stop it.
So instead of challenging the bull before a stadium packed with screaming women, you want me to fight it on the street in front of one dog and one child wearing a crude towel boy disguise? That's a terrible idea.
Here's a better one. You go get that billboard painted, and I'll reward you handsomely. Which is how I do everything. As an advance, I'll give you one of my secret weapons. Use it if anyone gets stuck.
This hatbox needs a hatbox tag.
I am the mighty Elodio!
You should really go out there and stop that bull.
Elodio and I will fight someday in the ring, and he will die. But not until we have a good media buzz first. So get out there and make that lazy dog paint my billboard.
Next up, Junior King Kong Cobra!
Hey, Edgar. Nice headgear, freak.
What?
What? You suck, Tegley. You can't beat me. Coach says I can't be beat. Coach says I got mental toughness. You can't break my concentration, wimp.
Hey, I'm not Edgar.
Yeah? You're gonna wish you're not Edgar when I'm through.
Look, I am not Edgar Tegley. My name's Raz. I'm a psychonaut.
You're an idiot, Smegley. Coach says your psycho girl crazy lack of focus cost you states.
Seriously, I don't want to have to hurt you.
Well, since you'd have to break my concentration to even touch me, and since you can't break my concentration, I guess you won't be too disappointed then. Feel that, because I didn't. Well, you can't hurt me at all. Because the coach taught me how to concentrate on not feeling the pain. Not like you, Smegley. I can't feel it. You'll never break my concentration. My head will never get all clouded up and confused like yours. I'm telling you, it's impossible. How about that? The coach says if you stay focused, you can't be beat. Does that hurt, little Edgar? Give it up, Spectre. Aw, oh, does that hurt?
I beat you just like I did in high school, loser. Wait, who am I? Hey, we really gotta get that billboard painted.
Okay, man, here's the plan. Step one, I quit we. Step two, we, which is now just you, runs out there and gets killed painting the billboard.
Maybe I can distract the bull while you paint. It's so crazy, it just might work.
Or maybe it's so crazy that it's just extra crazy. There's absolutely no way I'm going out there, man.
Come on, you're a bulldog. Show some backbone. Plus, who wants to go for a walk? Who wants to go for a walk?
Stupid dog. Brain. All right, let's go.
Great. When I say go, boy, get moving. Go, boy! Go, boy!
I can't take anymore. Why don't you confuse something else?
It's not great. But I suppose it's just barely good enough. Come see me if you still want your reward.
You know, your advice didn't work.
Really? Then here's some new advice. I don't know what you're talking about.
How about that reward?
Fine, then. One autograph.
You know, my bulldog friend could still paint a beer gut on that poster out there.
All right, here, take this. But I warn you, I won't be able to sign it.
This hatbox needs a hatbox tag. You should really go out there and stop that bull.
Elodio and I will fight someday, in the ring, and he will die.
I think it turned out pretty well. On the other hand, I'm colorblind.
I need the purse tag here. Here you go, Edgar.
Perfect. One step closer to her.
Some cards for you, Edgar.
Ah, that is exactly the card I need.
This one was a real pain in the butt to get.
Perfect. One step closer to her.
Here you go, Edgar. The last card.
Thank you. You said you would get them, and you did. Not everyone is as true to their word, you know.
Well, now you can finish your tower.
Yes. Now this can all end, once and for all.
Wow. It looks like you can walk right up there now, Edgar. Edgar? Edgar?
Save me someday. He just won't let me go. Tell me, how did you kill him?
Kill who?
Elodio.
I didn't. Edgar?
Magical creature. He can only be harmed by the traditional bullfighting weapons.
I can't pick those up by hand. I think TK is the thing.
Claudio is a fierce, magical creature. He can only be harmed by the traditional bullfighting weapons.
Thank you for preparing the bull, my humble picador. I shall now finish this beast off easily.
Edgar, listen. There is no Elodio, no Lampeta, no Dingo.
What?
You can't let the junior varsity pep squad ruin your life.
What's up with the junior?
Yeah, we were full on varsity.
Give me a G!
G!
Give me an O!
O!
Give me a B!
They stole my happiness! My life! The state semifinals! Everything!
No! Wait! Edgar!
Ha ha ha!
He never learns.
Oh no! I can't believe I stuck four of those barbed poles in his back.
They're called banderillas.
I gotta get those out of there and protect Edgar. If something happens to him while I'm in his mind, I'll get the boot. Can't get a good grip.
Elodio is a fierce, magical creature.
I think
he can only be harmed by the traditional bullfighting weapons.
Can't get a good grip.
Out! Here comes Elodio! Ow! Elodio's hit!
Elodio is a fierce, magical creature. He can only be harmed by the traditional bullfighting weapons.
Look out! Here comes Elodio!
Oh! Elodio doesn't like that!
Look out! Here comes Elodio!
Oh! Right in Elodio's butt!
Look out! Here!
Ow! Elodio is dying.